Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is a special edition of the Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a great one on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Dallas Cowboys. Kickoff is moments away, so let's get you out to our commentators. And standing by for the call are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, this storied franchise in Dallas and their fans are hungry and hopeful to add another championship banner in the rafters as we settle in for some playoff football at AT&T Stadium. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Seattle Seahawks and the Dallas Cowboys. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. This fielded at the two. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. And out will come the leader of this offense, and that, of course, is their signal caller.
I read something prepping for this game that he said prior to, and I think he really said it a few months ago, where he talked about he wants to have the type of season that at the end, he's buying gifts for all the guys who helped him along the way. And I know that the team wants to hold him to that and really get into his wallet. But that's what good leadership gives you. You know, at the end of the season, because you've done a great job, QB, he's usually the guy who springs for the...
And oh, right away, he lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Well, he's going to have to shake out the cobwebs first time he touches the football, and he drops it on the ground.
So many times we talk about quarterbacks and taking care of them early to get them in the flow with safe throws, right? But with a runner, there is no such thing as a safe run, right? Right out of the gate, you're going to be in some traffic. Got to take care of the ball, and he didn't do that.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And this is one of those bang-bang plays, Charles. Did the knee hit first or did the ball come out first?
This is where you need that 20/20 eyesight, don't you, Brandon? You've got to see which one happened first. If the knee hit the ground, then they will keep possession.
He'll drop to throw. He's got a man. It's Williams. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Now a first down carry by Bell, and able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42. The offensive starters now for the Cowboys.
An excellent year, obviously, because they got the open week, had the bye. But the one thing you always worry about, the rust factor. And I had a coach say to me one time, when you have that open week, you often think about scrimmaging so you're ready to go the next week. but you know you can't. So you cross your fingers and hope your guys are ready to roll.
And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. And a look at Seattle's defense.
When Bobby Wagner's career is said and done, people are going to look back and say he was an absolute steal in the NFL draft. A Pro Bowl player for any team.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down.
You got nothing.
They'll look to throw. And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Back deep for the Seahawks, Tyler Lockett. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. They're led onto the field by their quarterback, a man who's made quite the name for himself in the NFL, and that's Russell Wilson.
Coming off of a loss their last time out, I think he's just seeking to make a bigger impact on the game. He threw a touchdown pass, didn't throw an interception. I think he just wants to jump those numbers up in terms of flinging it around and letting his receivers get into the end zone.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. That's complete. It's Collins. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. To throw is Wilson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. And here's the starting offensive unit for Seattle.
And this is a unit that has to feel good about itself. Got the win last week in the wild card round, and oftentimes we say, you want to get the open week and get some rest, but many times we see the upsets happen with a team that won the week before and has momentum on its side.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked down inside the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
And from that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own 5.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
I guess it's good we can't really read the mind of the defensive coordinator now, huh?
Had him pinned back there deep, give up that run. Can't be happy.
Yeah, whatever is in his mind right now, we probably couldn't say over the air.
And now they have a little more space to maneuver from the 15, first and 10. They'll drop the throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They're going to look to throw. That one brought in by his tight end, Adam Shaheen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
It's just me and you.
On first down, Milton. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner. Second and nine now. On the crossing route, he hits his man, Amari Cooper. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle is going to be made at the Seahawks 35.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Back to throw. On the crossing route, complete. That's Gilbert. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. A first opportunity in the red zone for the Cowboys. They come up first and 10 at the 16. Now back to throw. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. A long way to go in this one. I'm sure that's not the only score we'll see today, but to jump out like that, very good.
Yeah, everyone wants to set the pace. You know, in a game like this, you want people chasing you. You don't want to be the team chasing them. That's exactly what they did.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Yeah, let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit
better. Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense.
So 5 yards there is one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, 1st and 10. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on 2nd down. Here's Wilson. Hey, right on cue, they set up the screen and complete it. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And they're going to be staring at a 3rd and long here. Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying it is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try to pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll punt it away for the second time. Did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the one-yard line.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the one-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They scored a touchdown the last time they had the football, but things are going to be a little bit more difficult this time.
Oh, certainly, because where they're starting, the goal isn't even thinking about a touchdown at this point. They're thinking about field position. A couple of first downs in order to give some room for their punter and maybe flip the field position for their defense. Really shouldn't be a surprise. It's going to be hard to move people in this situation. You know they're going to bring the pressure defensively. Because I remember playing in these spots, and my coaches always say, don't be afraid to try and create a safety, too. They're going to bring pressure. At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Now after the run by Bell, here's another first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Second and 3. Holmes has got it complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Watch tight, tight ends right. Watch tight, tight ends right. Four down, four down.
On play action, they'll throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Second and 10. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
This quarterback now, 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys a first and 10. They'll look to throw here. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
Single slot.
They'll set up to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because This is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
5 yards on the catch there brings up second down. And a look at the defense for the Cowboys.
Ha-ha Clinton Dix attracted a lot of attention when he was about to enter the NFL for his ability to play the football in the air. He's actually shown that he can tackle pretty well in the league, too.
Here's a second and five now from the 25. Now it's Hines. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 7 yards there and a first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. A loss of two there, second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. On second and 12, Wilson looking middle, and it's incomplete. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
Watch left, tight end to the left, tight end to the left. Hey, four down.
On third down, Wilson. This to Hines on the drop off. And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Now here's Michael Dixon as he's on to punt for Seattle. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. Juwan James, the right tackle, first-round selection in 2014. He's the one that got flagged there. This is brought in at the 21. Chris Carson trotting back out there. You can count his carries on one finger. They've only given him the rock one time, Charles. What gives?
So we can't draw any conclusions just yet. He has to touch the ball multiple times in order to get into a rhythm and have a chance to have success. You know who else gets into a rhythm? The offensive line. They feel better about what they're doing when they know they've had multiple opportunities to get it done.
Yeah, well, the conclusion we can draw so far, they're losing here in the second quarter. Let's see if they change tunes. Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. They were looking good on second down, but now they're backed up 5 yards by the false start, and it's second and 8. They run it with Carson. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a 3rd-and-1 situation. The Seahawks on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. This is Carson, and he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beef eaters on the interior of this D-line, You just know they were licking their chops on third and short. And yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stuffing that one short of a first down.
Well, we got beef eaters licking their chops and tasty dish in one fell swoop.
I did apologize in advance, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. That line's not eating tofu. I'll tell you that much for free.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of six. A gain of six there on first. From the 26, they'll line up on second and four. Now Bell, only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. The Cowboys on third down, just one for three thus far. Here it's third and two. Now flags fly in, and one of the Cowboys looked like he got going a little early. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down. And a manageable third down becomes a lot less manageable. Third and seven after the false start. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll come on to kick this one away. Returnable for Lockett. Now a late flag comes in as they got him down via the face mask, and that'll give him even better starting position. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
A lack of discipline defensively on fourth down, and now that leads to a first and 10. They go play action now. Wilson throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 10 yards and a Seattle first down. Wilson throwing quickly out to Lockett. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense. Exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
On second and 12, Wilson. He'll find Hines out of the backfield. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it's going to be third down and a ways to go here, third and 14. Well, they try to swing it on left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Couple of plays sent them the wrong way, and now they face a third and 14. Throwing again here, Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, we've seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, and it's second down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield, but that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly. Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays, didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. And he's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. A 46-yard punt, 8 yards on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Wilson gonna fake the give and keep it himself. And an alley to run. Down the numbers. There he goes. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. How big is that penalty? Wipe out the INT.
You'd hate to be the teammate that caused that penalty and wiped out the interception. You got to face that guy in the locker room. Not a lot of fun for you, and you hurt your squad.
No gain, and it's second down. Throwing on second down. Wilson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. First down, Seattle, 16 yards the gain there.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
They'll run on first down. It's Carson. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. From the 40 now on second down, Wilson. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. No gain there, and it's going to bring up a third down. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Now it's Wilson. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Cannon. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, and it's good for a first down as well.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Play action. It's Wilson. Over the middle, complete. That's Collins. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Oh,
Wilson going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's hit on all five of his pass attempts on this drive so far. Wilson going to fake the give and keep it himself. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away. But it does get away and it's second down. On second down now, it's Carson. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. The Seahawks on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 8. From the gun, it's Wilson. And that is incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So out now is the Seattle field goal team. And this one, a 41-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive gets them 3, not 6.
Is it okay if I give credit to both sides on this one?
Absolutely.
All right, let's start defensively. They hung in there, 10-play drive, but they stiffened when they got close to the goal line, made them kick a field goal. And for the offense, 10-play drive. They might be a little disappointed they got a field goal, but they moved the ball down the field with dispatch and came away with points.
And there is a flag as he's brought down right at the 25-yard line. But who's this going to be against? So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10.
I'm coming for you, son. I'm coming for you, son.
He'll drop to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete. So 2nd down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Brings up 2nd and 10 at the 40-yard line. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Only 2 there on the dump off. It's 3rd down.
51, Mike.
Looking to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Gilbert. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy 1st down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
2nd quarter action, 2 minutes to go on Divisional Round Weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful Divisional Round Weekend. Bell running on 1st down, but he's going to get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there, 2nd down. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 27-yard line.
The beauty of route running is it doesn't matter what position. Everyone's doing the same thing. In this case, tight end selling the vertical route. Get the defensive back on his heels, break off for the corner. And with good timing, you get a completion as we just saw there.
So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, now we're going to New York, right? That's Command Central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
Back to throw now on 1st down. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. He'll look to throw. That's complete. It's Bell. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
This quarterback now closing in on a 200-yard first half through the air. It's first and 10. And this is caught. It's Cooper. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Second and 2. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Looking again that time for Amari Cooper, and it's third and short. After the incompletion, here now, third and 2. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes this a 9-point game. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with a Le'Veon Bell touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Chris Carson trotting back out there. He's just been looking for some space. Yeah, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people, find some other playmakers, but always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
I was going to say, don't forget about it.
No, don't take him totally out of the game.
Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson. That's taken in, complete to Reynolds. Now the Seahawks call the second of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now it's Carson, and nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Looking to throw on second down. Wilson, that's into the hands of Reynolds. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. A gain there of 21 yards. An inaugural trip to the red zone here for the Seahawks. They've got a first and 10 at the 11. From the shotgun, Wilson. That's complete right around the 8. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And his kick is right there. It's good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So, yes, they'll still be down going into intermission, but the depth. deficit is now made even smaller, very manageable.
Yeah, and if nothing haywire happens here in his last couple of precious seconds, they will go into the locker room with a nice bounce in their step, having gotten a little bit closer on the scoreboard.
We got this.
So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC Divisional Round matchup as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, this is the second of four games this weekend as we narrow the field down to the four teams who will meet in the league championship games next Sunday. We'll get back out to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look ahead to tomorrow's other Divisional Round game in the NFC. And it looks like we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, in our game, we're set up for a terrific second half. So to find out who will advance to the NFC title game, let's send it back out to Brandon God.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. To throw is Wilson, and his throw's going to be incomplete. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Oh, he can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get him to fourth down. It appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half, still down by that slim margin.
Yeah, and that's okay. You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they, on the sidelines, go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done. Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
Now it's Lockett. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Throwing again, Wilson. That's complete. It's Collins. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That one good for 14 and a Seahawk first. Throw left side complete. It's Collins. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Right there, 54 Mike. Hey, I'm coming.
On second down, it's Carson. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. They get 9 yards back on the run there, and they're left with a much more makeable third and two.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? But it definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
And out now come the Cowboys. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory. Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Second and 6. Over the middle, complete. That's Gilbert. And able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Back to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. But forget the run on 3rd and 1. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
This quarterback now, 5 straight completions here in this second half, 1st and 10. He'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. On first down, Bell. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run. Second and 5. And he's got his man on the out route. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 25-yard line.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
They'll run on first down. It's Bell. Bell, a first down and then some. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, his second touchdown of the night. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. A good sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. They'll try and throw for it. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go!
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Wilson. And his throw here is incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. And he comes back with one complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Seven catches for him now, and this last one, a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Wilson now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. Here's Carson. And now running right through him. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. They run the counter. Hines. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. First down Seattle on a pickup of 13.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. This is Hines. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Hey, check Mike 57.
On second down now, it's Carson. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19.
All day, baby. Let's go. Let's go.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Green 80.
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. He'll find Reynolds over the middle. And a good gain here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. To throw again on second down. Wilson, they'll try and set up the screen to Hines. Ninth play coming up here on this drive. This is third and a yard. And to give this time to the tailback. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They only got 2, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it first and goal.
There are a lot of different formulas to winning football, but one constant over the years, winning on third down. That pickup there was big because they had struggled throughout this one.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They run again with Carson, and he is in for the Seattle touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run as his guys are back within a single score. He has been an integral part of the offense all season, and now in the playoffs he's carrying it over. Had the touchdown last week in the wild card game, now his second TD of the playoffs.
Showing some consistency, and that's something that we have to keep in mind about the playoffs, because we often think you have to be spectacular in order to win. I think consistent is what you're looking for. That can get you to the finish line.
Extra point right down the middle, and that will shave one more off this lead. A 5-point game now as here comes the kickoff. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Le'Veon Bell making his way back out onto the field now. He is hoping to find the end zone for a third time, and we sit now in the third quarter.
And nothing would excite him more, but I think even more so, his offensive line. Anytime you've got a guy scoring that many times, that means you've done a really nice job in front of him.
You're always giving props to the big fellas up front.
It's always a good idea. Those are some massive men.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. 2nd and 4. And he's got the hook up to Moore. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. This quarterback now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. 1st and 10. This is Bell. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Single receiver. Hey, you're on an island over there.
2nd and 9 now. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Bobby Wagner. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Cowboys on third down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This is 3rd and 17. They'll look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 40. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's 1st and 10, right at the 40. Back to throw here. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Second and one. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Gilbert. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 15-yard line.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw to the goal line, but it's incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Second and 10. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. That catch good for 5. It's third down. They'll set up a throw. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory. A 28-yard attempt.
Butker's kick here is good, and that'll push the lead up to 8. But from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Let's go.
Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. Right now, Charles, this is the drive of the season. You're on the road here in the playoffs. It's put up or shut up. They need points.
This is where you have to come together as a team, as you just noted, on the road. So that means they've carried that mentality with them throughout. Hey, we've got to go on the road. We've got to rely on ourselves, right? Focus, yet still find the fun in it. How great is this, guys? Look at the spot we're in right now. And then go to your top players, call the plays that they run best.
Yeah, sort of controlling their own destiny, but this place has been loud. Not going to be easy. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Wilson, after the play fake to Carson. It's caught, Lockett. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards, the final tally.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, You really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson throwing over the middle, but it's... incomplete. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts. Throwing again here, Wilson. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete. They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. To throw again is Wilson. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. This Cowboy defense trying to hold him out of the end zone. They've run it to third and goal. They'll try to run with Hines. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. A three-yard loss. Fourth down now.
I know this is your spot, partner, so forgive me for jumping in, but there's no decision right here. They have to go for it in this situation. They're down on the scoreboard. How many other opportunities are you going to get?
Yeah, I'm with you. Fourth quarter, like you said, down on the scoreboard. And remember here, a field goal virtually does them no good. They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. From 6 yards away, as they now sit just a two-point conversion away from tying this game up in the fourth quarter.
Fourth and goal, and they found a way to throw it in the end zone for a touchdown.
And these defenses, they just like three downs, get off the field. But here they had to go four, couldn't get it done.
A lot of the time, you're looking up and saying, okay, if I hold them for three, at worst, I give up a field goal attempt. When they go for it, sometimes it really affects the defense because maybe they're not mentally prepared to go that fourth down.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. And the failure to convert and tie the game, now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down one. What's the sense? I like what they did.
So the lead shaved to two now as the kickoff is away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Bell with a first down carry there as he'll get about four out of that. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Again, it's Bell. It's a 6 yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And this is caught. He hits more. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Back to throw now on first down. He gets this complete to Shaheen, the tight end.
They don't want it.
Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and nine. Now a draw play. This is Bell. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
And this is why the head coach gets paid the big bucks. Look at where they are in this situation, partner. Do you throw the ball here in a long-distance situation? Do you run it again and trust your defense and make sure you take care of the ball and punt it away? What kind of options do you have here, and what do you trust more on your team?
Yeah, they may have just pushed him back into that throwing situation. We'll see. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Looking to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 13. From the shotgun, Wilson. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Complete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
I'm coming for you. You mine.
Wilson now to throw again. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. That's complete. It's Collins. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Little costly there. You wipe out the first down. You also move further back.
No doubt about it. So you went from moving the sticks to them staying in the same spot, except for that one guy carrying the yard marker. He moves back farther.
Now here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
Play action, it's Wilson. His throw incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Wilson, going to throw again. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Now they'll try to convert on third and six after the four-yard completion. To throw is Wilson. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Collins. 6 catches in the wild card victory last week, and now 6 catches here and a first down.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into an either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
So a challenge is upon us. I tell you, close game, fourth quarter. This is a huge decision.
Oh, no doubt about that, partner. A lot has to be riding on this call. And you know, it is a tight one because it has to be indisputable visual evidence in order to change it. Now here's the big question. Do they actually have that evidence?
We're about to find out.
Wilson's pass. Complete to number 89.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice or the pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Defense.
A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
Right there, right there, 54 Mike. I got you.
On second down, here's Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
Maybe a frustration penalty there because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, 5 defensive backs. They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback never got rid of the football.
Some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Wilson. And the catch made by Johnson. That catch good for 5. It's third down. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
And the penalty helps, but not a whole lot. It's still third and long. They go play action with Wilson. And he will find his man on the outside. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And this one is right through. And with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the fourth. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing? This
will be taken in at the one. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
A gain of six there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion. So here's second and four. They'll run it with Bell. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to let it fly. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Here's Bell. It was Mike Hilton up to make the tackle. The Cowboys looking to get going again in a hurry. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. He was looking to hit his running back, Le'Veon Bell, that time. And that'll make it third down. Back to throw. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. This defense not going to lag back. They come with pressure that time, force him out of the pocket, and the incompletion.
And so many times when you're watching a game, you're seeing the offense doing all the dictating. In this case, the defense said, we're dictating the terms, and turned it loose towards him.
So a big one coming now for Harrison Butker. This for the lead in the final stages. And the kick by Butker is good. And they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. Big kick right there to give him the lead in the fourth, but there is still time left for a final drive.
Did they score too soon? Post-game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they manage the clock exactly right.
This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So Russell Wilson in the offense, down by 2, a little over 80 ticks to go. A field goal would produce a playoff stunner on the road, but this crowd is going to let him hear it here on first down. Now Wilson. Throw left side complete. It's Collins. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. He'll look to throw.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice hit, boys.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Here we go. Here we go.
From midfield now, here's Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer, defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Here's Wilson. This complete to Lockett. 7 yards there and a first down. On first down, Carson. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game. On third down, it's Carson. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field. And now it all rests on the right foot of their kicker. And his kick is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. Well, sometimes you get a mismatch in these divisional round games. Not here. This has been everything we could have hoped for.
Okay, Brandon, don't get mad at me, but it's time for the old cliche.
Bring it.
Neither of these teams deserves to lose, but in the end, it's looking like the late field goal is going to be the difference in this game.
That's a good cliche. We'll let that one go.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
Well, on both sides, you come into this game with so much hope, so much buildup, looking to move on. One side gets to do that, but let's not forget the others. Tough pill to swallow.
It really is, because it's so much hard work, effort. You mentioned the hope to go on and maybe play in the big game itself. Well, let's see how they handle it, though. The offseason is going to be a long one for them because it's going to eat their heart out watching other people continue to play. But can they come back the next year and find it in them to make that same run again and maybe find a way to advance?
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. Good night, everybody.